All right, what's up everyone? Welcome back to another course vlog video. Today we're at Morro Bay again. Sorry we're playing here again, but it's just been really hot and slow. Regardless though, I'm playing from the tips today, so spice things up. It's an extra 400 yards, I think. But first tee, as usual, just because it's the first hole, I'm honestly just swinging as hard as I can and just praying it goes far, just because it can go anywhere. And I kind of hooked this thing left, but it's fine because we're still in the rough. With that being said, I only hit it 200, so I take my 3-wood, and there's so much room up there that I pretty much swing as hard as I can. It's the first hole, not expecting much, just trying to get it near the green. But I got 110 yards in for my third shot, and I got my 50 degree in my hand. You guys know I freaking love this club. I had a kind of a downhill weird lie, ball beneath my feet, but I had a great shot. It's a perfect start on the first hole, leaving me with about, I'd say like 12 feet for par. And as you guys watch this video, this is going to be the story today. I could not figure out the greens. They're playing at godspeed levels. It was unbelievable. It was every putt was a prayer. That being said, even through one, perfect start. Exactly where I want to be. Second hole, 440 from the tips. It's quite difficult, especially when the wind's going. And I do my specialty, snap it into the left rough. But I hit it pretty good, 240. So I got 200 in, and I'm playing new irons, and I duff it. I straight duff it. Goes like 30 yards, and leaving me with 155 in. It's the second hole, getting the jitters out. And this was just pure shank city. Almost killed my playing partner. Nightmare. I'm freaking out right now. But I take a deep breath, I slow down, and I hit a good 56 shot. Now, I probably should have hit my 50, and I leave it short, but it's fine. We're putting, just trying to minimize the damage, close the wound. No more salt in the wound. And as this putt, I just could not figure out the greens, leaving me with an eggy 9-foot putt. This is scary, but I saved double, so 2 over through 2. It's an okay start. Hole 3, my famous 3-wood into the trees. It's like a replica video, honestly. It's crazy when you play course a lot, you do the same things over and over and over again. Now I have the most awkward, queer lie. I'm in the roots, on like a root system, and I hit a great shot. It peered it with my 50. I wasn't swinging that hard because I was kind of nervous. Leaving me about 13 yards in for my chip. Now, I decided not to trace the chips today just because I wanted to maybe see what you guys thought. As you see, I bounced it in. And it was a good chip, leaving me with about 5, 6, 7 feet. But at the Morro Bay greens, this is feels like a 30-footer. Regardless, though, great putt. I just didn't have the speed. I mean, that's 3 holes in a row where I just couldn't get the speed down. And that's just going to be the theme of the day. All right, par 3, hole 4. I have my 46 degree, which is a wedge. Playing new irons, I set it, and I just blade this thing. It was an ugly shot. My right shoulder flared, leaving me a 15-yard chip, and I had a really, really proud. I was stoked on this chip, but again, you know, the theme of the day, 6-7 feet downhill for par. It's not somewhere you want to be on these greens. I was back home and playing those courses in Orange County. The greens are just a lot easier. With these public courses, you never know what you're gonna get. Regardless, bogey golf, 4 through 4. It's early, you know how it is. 18 holes, it takes a while to warm up. And in this video, I am gonna come out the second part. I get to hole 16, so you'll get to see a lot. But I had a great, great drive. I usually do on this hole, leaving me with about 100 in with my 50. I full swing just because it's uphill. And I take a good divot, as you can see. I was happy. Middle probably middle back of the green. I was here in my last video. I guess usually where I end up with the pin in the back. Now, again, you're going to see this. The uphill putts today are just ugly. Ugly, ugly, ugly putt. The thing broke about 3 or 4 feet. I had it straight. Just misread. I even add this the frustration. Usually putting's my strong suit, so that's why I get kind of worked up. Leaving me 5 feet, 6 feet? Wow. Three putts, regulation green. That's, you lose sleep over those. And then this just works right into a dead slice into these trees. I hit it 30 yards. So I got 300 yards in. It's playing like a par four when I lose a stroke. I take my 5-iron, just trying to get it up there. Hit a pretty good shot, like a low stinger. Hit it like 200 yards. For the 5-iron, I was really happy with that. I have about 100 yards in on this, and I was had it playing like 90, 95. So I hit a pretty soft, choked up 50 degree. And at this point, I'm just trying to minimize the damage, walk away with a bogey. Maybe, but I hit a great shot, leaving me a par opportunity. And I'm looking at this right now, and I'm thinking, oh, what? I have it like 2 balls, 3 balls. I mean, this thing just... It was honestly just a crappy read and a crappy putt. That's what, we're on hole 6 right now. That's 6 bad putts. And I don't even take my time on this, but this should have been, that was not a gimme. It was a head down, just put it in. All right, we're 6 over through 6. I need something to happen. As you can see, I had a great swing. I kept my shoulders steady, hit a straight shot. And from the tips, just lands in the fairway, which is awesome. I'm having, 123 in. I got my wedge, my 46 degree. And I just played it. I have not hit a good wedge shot. But believe it or not, you're probably wondering, why is there music playing? Well, it's because I freaking sank this thing. Watch this. Yeah, pretty unbelievable, huh? For birdie. That's what I needed. I needed something like that. So now we're 5 over. You love birdies. That's why I come back to this course. It's par 3, though, 232 yards. I don't even have a club that I can control going that far. So I hit my hybrid, probably 210. It's perfect. It's from the tips. The par 3s are just scary. Just scary holes. Especially on this course. So I got 21 in. Downhill lie. Hit a good shot. I just left it short. As you can see. And this green's kind of like an ice rink. It's open to the wind. And this putt broke, look at that, 4 or 5 feet. It looks flat. I had 2 balls and it broke 800 balls. And even then, I should take my time on those putts. On the back nine, you'll see I screw up on one. But that's fine. 6 over. That's a bogey hole in the last one, so I'll take that any day. This hole and hole 2, as you guys know, I play this course a lot. Your drives are critical, and I hit a nuke. It was like 295 yards, probably the farthest ball I've ever hit. It was smashed. So I have my 7 degree in my hand, and I chunk it. Oh, I did not hit one iron good on the front nine. But a little foreshadowing, I play really good on the back with my irons. They're brand new. I haven't really gone to the range with them yet, so I'm still getting used to them. But I got a scary chip, and I flop. And I thought I left it short, but this thing ran on, as you can see. Oh, I kind of left it short. But it rolled on, leaving me about 3 feet for par. But yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. The